Hello everyone and welcome to CADCAM CE tutorials. This is the fifth part in series of handwash dispenser assembly, and in this video we are going to assemble all those parts that we have created in the previous videos. So let's begin it. Now let us first close it and we'll go for a file. Select here assembly and OK. Now first we'll close it and we'll make background plain white. Now first we'll create the top assembly of handwash dispenser, and in the end we'll insert the container of the handwash dispenser. To create the top assembly we'll insert all the components one by one, and then we'll apply constraint between the parts. So to insert all the components we'll go for the insert components. Select here browse and go to the folder where we have created all the parts, that is on the desktop, and the name of the folder is handwash dispenser. Now in this folder you can find all the components that we have created in the earlier parts. Now we'll insert cover as a first component and click on open. Now for the first component we'll go for default placement. Now we'll insert the second component, and for that we'll go for the insert components. Go for the browse and we'll select here washer as a second component and click on open. Now for the washer we have to apply the constraint between the washer and the cover, so we'll go for the mat. Now we'll select here this cylindrical portion of the washer, and with this portion we'll select here the cylindrical portion of the cover. For both these faces we'll go for the concentric as a constraint and click on OK. Now after that we'll select here this top face of the washer, and with this face we'll select here this bottom face of the cover. For both these faces we'll go for the coincident as a constraint and click on OK. Now we have placed washer, so we'll exit the mat. After inserting the washer we'll go for the third component, and that is the retainer. So we'll go for the insert component, browse, and we'll select a retainer and we'll open it. Now for the retainer also we'll go for the mat. Now we'll select here this cylindrical face of the cover and select here this cylindrical face of the retainer. For both these faces we'll go for the concentric and click on OK. Now we'll drag the retainer over here like this. After that we'll select here this top face of the cover, and with that face we'll select here this bottom face of the retainer. For both these faces we'll go for the coincident as a constraint and click on OK. Now we'll exit the mat. Now we'll go for the fourth component, and for that we'll go for the insert component, browse. Now fourth component is spring stem, so we'll select your spring stem and click on open. Now for the fourth component we'll again go for the mat. Now we'll select here the cylindrical face of the spring stem and select here cylindrical face of the cover. For both the faces we'll go for the concentric, but we want to flip the direction, so we'll select here this flip mat alignment and click on OK. After inserting this component we'll drag it over here like this. Now we'll select here this face of the spring stem, and with this face we'll select here this bottom face of the retainer. Between both these faces we'll go for the coincident as a constraint and click on OK. Now we'll exit the mat. Now we'll go for the fifth component, so we'll select here insert components, browse, and select here press handle as a fifth component and click on open. Now for this fifth component we'll go for the mat. Now we'll select here the cylindrical face of the spring stem and select here this cylindrical face of the press handle. For both this we'll go for the concentric as a constraint and click on OK. After that we'll select here this top face of the spring stem, and with that face we'll select here this face of the press handle. For both these faces we'll go for the coincident as a constraint and click on OK. Now we'll rotate the press handle, and for that we'll go for the assembly. Now we'll select here the right plane of the cover, select here right plane. With that plane we'll go for the press handle, and in the press handle we'll select here the front plane of the press handle, and click on OK. Now we'll exit the mat. Now we'll go for the sixth component, and that is the spring housing. So we'll go for the insert component, browse, and then we'll select here spring housing and click on open. Now for the spring housing, we'll go for the mat. Then we'll select here the cylindrical face of the cover, and then we'll select here cylindrical face of the spring housing. For both this, we'll select here concentric as a constraint and click on OK. After inserting this, we'll drag it like this. Now we'll select here this top face of the spring housing, and with that face we have to select here this bottom face of the washer. For both these faces, we'll go for the coincident as a constraint and click on OK. Now we'll exit the mat. Now we'll go for the seventh component. So insert component, click on this browse, and then we'll select here spring as a seventh component and click on open. Now we'll place spring over here. Now after that, we'll create a cross section of this assembly so that we can correctly place the spring. And for that, we'll select here the cross sectional view. Now from here, we'll select the right plane of this cover as a cutting plane. So select here right plane and click on OK. Now after creating the cross sectional view, we have to place the spring over here. And for that, from this we'll select here the axis, so that axis will be visible to us. Now after creating the axis as a visible, we'll go for the mat. Now we'll select here this axis, and then we'll select here the cylindrical face of the spring stem. For both this, we'll select here concentric as a constraint and click on OK. Now after that, we have to place the spring correctly, and for that we'll first close the mat. Now we'll select here spring and we'll place it correctly. So as you know that we have placed the spring correctly. So we'll exit the cross sectional view. Now we'll insert the tube, and for that we'll go for the insert components. Select here browse, and then we select here tube and open. Now for the tube also, we'll go for the mat. Then we select here the cylindrical face of the tube and select here cylindrical face of the spring housing. For both this, we'll select here concentric as a constraint and click on OK. Now let us first break the spring over here. Now after that, we'll select here the top face of the tube, that is this face, and with this face we'll select here this face of the spring housing, that is over here. For both the faces, we'll go for the distance as a constraint and enter here distance as a 10 mm and click on OK. So this is the top assembly of hand hose dispenser. Now we'll exit the mat, and from here we'll make this axis height. Now after creating this top assembly, we'll go for the insert components. Again we'll go for the browse, and then we'll select here container. OK. Now for the container, we'll go for the mat. Then we'll select here the cylindrical face of the cover, and select here cylindrical face of this container. For both this face, we'll go for the concentric as a constraint and click on OK. After that, we'll select here this face of the container, and with this face we'll select here this bottom face of this cover, and for both this we'll go for the coincident as a constraint and click on OK. Now after that, we have to align this, and for that we'll go for the assembly tree. Select here right plane of the cover, and with that plane we'll go for the container, and from the container we have to select here the front plane. Now for both this plane, we'll go for the coincident as a constraint and click on OK. Now we'll exit the mat. Now here you can see that in this video we have created assembly of all the parts that we have created in the previous videos. So this is the assembly of the hand hose dispenser, And in the next video, we'll go for the rendering of this assembly so that this assembly will look like a real part. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like this video, then please hit on the like button, share it, and subscribe to this channel, CAD CAM C Tutorials.